Hello dear students, in this video I will discuss about the knowledge, reasoning and the logic and will be represented that how we can convert a knowledge into the logic. So before going into that, let us discuss about one example. Rohan is a man, this is one fact is given. So Rohan is a man, in short we can represent it as a Rohan man. Similarly, if we write Rajat is a man, then we can represent it as Rajat man, right? So both have, but the thing is that the both have no similarities, that Rohan man, Rajat man, there is a no similarities are there in that format. So what we can do, we can rewrite it in this way, that Rohan is a man, that is a man, within a bracket we can give the object, that is a name of the man, that is a Rohan. Similarly, Rajat is a man, we can write it in the same format, that is man, within bracket the object, that is a Rajat. So in this way we can easily represent the fact into the logic. Now I'm coming to another example. Spot is a dog. Spot is a dog, that means we can represent it as dog within bracket Spot. So that means a Spot is the name of a dog. Now it is written that all dog has tail. All dog has tail. Okay, so all dog, that is one part, and another part is has tail, right? So for all dog we will write the phrase in this way, this is for all sign. This is for all sign. We are taking one variable x which will be denoted by for the dogs, right? So for all x colon dog x, fine. So basically by writing the x we are representing each and every dogs, whatever the name is, we are representing it with a variable, implies has tail x. So has tail x means x has a tail. So x may be a Spot, so Spot has a tail, right? So as a conclusion we can write it, so if these two facts are true, if these two facts are true, then we can come to the conclusion that Spot has a tail, as Spot is also a dog. So we are comparing these two particular phrases, this and this. So here also Spot is written, though Spot is not a variable, x is a variable, we are replacing it x with a Spot. So we will get it that has tail within bracket Spot. So we can write has tail Spot. So this is how from some facts we can come to some other facts, right? Now problem mapping is a very important part of this chapter, that is all dog have tails and every dog has a tail. So it seems like similar, that all dog have tails and every dog has a tail, maybe the same fact, but still if we are going to write it using the logic, then we have to be very careful, right? So the meaning may be every dog has at least one tail. Every dog has at least one tail, the meaning may be this, or the meaning may be each dog has several tails. That may be also another meaning, right? Or there is a tail that every dog has. So we have to be very careful before writing any logic or any fact, that what the fact exactly represents. Okay, so we should not be having any writing any kind of fact with having ambiguities like this. Remember about this problem. So structure of a fact is basically initial facts are this given, and internal representation of the facts are will be there, and the final facts will be generated. So approach to knowledge representation. For example, three players are given with their heights and weights, bat throw, Fine. So all the data are given in a tabular format. Now we can map in this way who is the heaviest player. So what we will do, we will compare the weight, and whatever the weight is, maximum weight, we will fetch the corresponding player name. So here the 72 is the highest weight, and we'll fetch the corresponding player name, that is C. So this is one kind of representation. So inheritable knowledge is one node is going to another node applying some conditions. We have already done this before when we have learnt about more about the artificial intelligence, how we can come from one node to another node, that we can do. So we can do it to inherit the knowledge also. So from one node to another node, when a node changing are being done, that time some changes we can see within the nodes. So that changes can come only by applying some conditions, that is by some actions by the agent or by something else. Okay, so for that reason the another nodes come. So this is the inheritable knowledge. For example, this is the example of the semantic network. The phrase is Ram gives a pen to Rahim. Ram gives a pen to Rahim. Here the semantic network, we can represent it in this way, that Ram is a giver, Rahim is a receiver. What is the function? That is a give. And what is the object? That is the pen. So this is the sample example of the semantic network. So I'm going into another example of this. Okay, suppose we are writing man is mortal. Okay, man is mortal. So we can write it as mortal within bracket man. No, that will not be the correct way. Man is mortal, so mortal within mortal, the man we cannot write, because man itself is a we have to write the man outside of the bracket, as it is not a name of anything, right? So how we can represent it? We can represent it man mortal, that means the meaning will be like that. Mortal is a man, that means a mortal is a name of a man. We have already seen this earlier time, Rohan man, Rahul man. So man within bracket we used to write the Rohan. So Rohan is a name of a man. So if we write in this way, that man within bracket mortal, that will also be an incorrect approach. Okay, that is also be an incorrect approach. So what we will do, the solution is this. For all x, man x is mortal x. That means for all x, x is basically the whole fraternity of the man. The name can be anything, x is a working as a variable. So man x implies mortal x. So suppose the name is Ram. Okay, so man Ram is mortal Ram. That means Ram is a man, that means Ram is mortal. So that is how we can represent the fact. So here some set of representation is given, set of facts are given, that is Marcus was a man. Okay, Marcus was a Pompeian, all Pompeians were Romanians. Caesar was a ruler, all Romans were either loyal to Caesar or hated him. Everyone is loyal to someone. People only try to assassinate rulers if they are not loyal to. Marcus tried to assassinate Caesar. So that these eight facts are given. We have to convert it into the predicates. Fine. So the first fact given was Marcus was a man. So that means we can represent it in this way, man within bracket Marcus. So Marcus is a man name. Fine. Next one is Marcus was a Pompeian. So Pompeian is basically a set of people from a set of region or having some same language. Okay, so Pompeian was Marcus was also a Pompeian. He was a Romanians as well as a Pompeians. For example, you are an Indian as well as you are an Bengali. So this is how you can generate this. The next fact is all Pompeians were Romans, because the Pompeians are available only in the Romans. So all Pompeians were Romans. That means for all X, Pompeian X implies Roman X. Fine. Next is Caesar was a ruler. So Caesar is a name. Ruler is a designation. So ruler within bracket Caesar. Next is all Romans were either loyal to Caesar or hated him. So all Romans, we can denote it as for all X Roman X, for all Romans, for all X Roman X were either loyal to Caesar, or hated him. So two phases are there. We have to use or sign over there. So or sign is basically the V sign. We can see this sign as a war sign. So either loyal to Caesar. So loyal to is a phase. So loyal to Caesar. That means loyal to Caesar. Who is loyal? The X, all Romans. So the who is loyal to whom is loyal? Two objects are there. So who is loyal? That we will write within this. And to whom they are loyal? We will write it in the second object. So loyal to within bracket X comma Caesar. Or hated him. That means hate. Who is hating? X is hating, so X is the first object. To whom he is hating? Caesar. Caesar is the next object. So hate X comma Caesar. Next fact is everyone is loyal to someone. It is very critical part. A little bit critical part. Not to worry. Everyone, we can denote the everyone as for all X, right? Loyal to someone. So loyal to who are loyal? X is loyal to whom? So to whom part we can represent as Y. So loyal to is a function. There should be two object. One is who is loyal. Second one is to whom he is loyal. So who is loyal? We know that everyone is loyal. That is for all X, X is loyal. To whom he is loyal? For that we are taking another object Y. So here it is written that everyone is loyal to someone. For all X, loyal to X, Y. Another thing is there. Everyone is loyal to someone. That means there are exist someone to whom everyone is loyal to. Either a son is loyal to his mother. Or a teacher is loyal to his job. Or father is loyal to his family. So there somebody should be there to whom everyone is loyal to. So that exist sign we will denote by this sign. Okay, this is exist sign. So for all X exist Y, loyal to X comma Y. Fine. So this is how it should be written. Next is people only try to assassinate rulers they are not loyal to. Okay. So people only try to assassinate rulers. So we can denote people as X here. I have written person X. You can write man X also. Fine. But only man cannot come within people because it may be having man or woman. Okay. So I have written person X, you can denote it man X, both are correct. Logically both are correct. So for all X, right, for all Y, so X, the definition of X is person X or man X. This is and sign and ruler Y. Try to assassinate is another phase. So try to assassinate. Who is trying to assassinate X? To whom he is trying to assassinate Y? They are not loyal to implies this is the not sign. This sign is the not sign, loyal to X comma Y. they are not loyal to x comma who is not loyal x to whom is not loyal y. Fine, it's very easy, not to worry. Next is Marcus tried to assassinate Caesar. Marcus tried to assassinate, so tried to assassinate, we can write it in this way, Marcus comma Caesar, who is trying to and to whom is trying to. Now it's turn to convert a predicate into the clause, so this predicate is given. From this predicate, can anyone assume that what is the fact? Here it is written that for all x, Roman x, and this is the and sign, no x comma Marcus. That means for all Romans, who knows Marcus? For all Romans, who knows Marcus implies. Now this second line we have to read it very carefully. That is, hate x comma Caesar, and this is this is or sign or this part. So we can write it in this way: for all Romans who know Marcus is either hate Caesar or. Now or in or part this phrase will come. Here it is written that for all y exist z, hate y comma z, think crazy x comma y. So think crazy x comma y, or think crazy to someone. This someone is basically y. Okay, think crazy to someone. Okay, someone who hate someone. So basically we are writing another again I'm writing for all Romans. Romans is basically the x. Who knows Marcus is either hate Caesar or think crazy to all the people who hate someone. Think crazy about all the people who hate someone. This someone is basically Z. Okay, so this is the fact behind this. Okay, in my next video I will discuss about thoroughly about how to convert the predicate into the clause. Hope you like my video. If you like my video, then do subscribe my channel and wait for the upcoming videos which will help you in your study. Thank you.